Over the last month, the board members have visited 34 buildings, departments, and ceremonies to personally recognize contribution to student achievement, learning, and teaching. It's been our honor to recognize and thank all who were nominated for their contributions and service to the Central High School District and community. There were 705 total certificates of nomination. They were given to 404 nominees. That was divided into 229 certificated, 91 classified individuals, 60 employee teams, and 24 community members and organizations were nominated. So that is really an exciting time to recognize all those individuals. From these extraordinary nominations, the school board has selected this year's district-wide Meritorious Service Award recipients. And we have 10 that we will honor tonight. So we will begin by starting with Landa. We'll go through the school.
So far, no. Oh, it's on. Oh, so far, yes. So it's my honor tonight to recognize Val Clapper. Would you come up, Val? a couple decades ago, I was working here in Central Valley, and I was working with the director of Title I and LAP, and she was telling me about the new hires. And she said, "I can't wait for you to meet Val Clapper." She said, "She's going to be a leader, Terry." And I'm here tonight to tell Marcia Tate, you were right, Marcia. So Val, it's really nice. When I was reading these things out, it going to the different schools and presenting the school nominees, and when I was printing out this one for tonight, I was listening to my printer at home, and it was, you know, kept spitting out. I said, "What have I done? You know, did I ask for 20 copies of this?" No, Val has 20 nominations. Her school, Montrose Elementary, her staff, her students, her parent community, they appreciate her. They love her. I'm briefly going to summarize 20 nominations. That's why I was a little bit late. So some of the words that they use to describe Val, Val is an academic interventionist, so she works with all grade levels. Some of the words were sensitive, skilled, driven, efficient, selfless, tireless champion of the developing reader, organized, excellent communicator. That list goes on and on. What Val does is she works with individual kids or small groups who are identified as needing, like, the tier two intervention to help them learn to read. Many kids learn to read with tier one, many don't. And so we do have this program, but Val never gives up on a student. Besides that, she is in professional development with her staff, always researching what are some new ways we can reach these kids, what other ideas can I give their classroom teacher to help this student become successful and be a competent reader. Beyond her professional skills in that realm, words were used about Val's heart and how kind she is, how kids can't wait for their turn to go with Val. And that teacher that wrote that, I don't know. Her love of students, unquestionably giving her time, even wanting to give her prep time to get one more kid help. So with all of that, I was going to sum it up with this. She goes above and beyond to help each student with specialized instruction to guide them to the next level. And when things work, she compliments the other staff members working with them and rarely taking credit for the work she did. Val is expert in her field and she's always willing to help anyone. So congratulations to Val.
I have the next one, and it's Mark Betts. Mark is a teacher. However, in practice, Mark is a teacher. However, in practice, you are so much more than that. When students enter the classroom, they're immediately placed in the driver's seat. They control what they learn and to what extent they learn it. They get to design projects and discover the manufacturing pathway. You are there to guide and challenge each and every student. It's not common that you find students finding new ways for them to do it, because Mark encourages that. He asks them questions, gives them self-assess, and encourages them to grow in their skill set. They transcend the walls of the classroom as well. You want all students to learn and explore. He makes makerspace where any student can work with tools and try new things. Within that group, he sets students up as peer mentors to share their learning. He creates a collaborative environment. You know, a student writes, "You're a better teacher. You're one of the best." He teaches about problem solving by letting you mess up. He's not afraid to admit that he doesn't know something, but he teaches you things you would never learn in a trade school and encourages you to have fun. Mark has a positive impact on our entire and the trade show of innovation. These FBT staples depend on the time and effort Mark puts into them, and our students learn how to be collaborative, problem solve, question, and create through their task. These two events help all students grow. They're in the pursuit of learning and to assist in creating a culture that we have at FBT. It's with great honor we give you this award. Thank you, Mark, for all that you do.
Good evening. It is my honor to recognize Ross Johnson from Broadway Elementary School. Ross is a ray of sunshine that holds the look. Well, I have a lot more to say. That was a really big try. Ross has brought fun, new ideas, and an amazing positive attitude with him to Broadway. And more than just positivity and fun, his work is driven by a deep focus on creating a sense of belonging for all and creating systems and structures that benefit all our students. Here are just a few examples. A sense of belonging, which is the district motto this year. Ross was instrumental in creating our new Broadway motto about belonging. Fun activities for students. I wish I went to a school. To include everyone in our sense of community, he came up with the idea of doing daily Zoom announcements. And he talked his principal into doing it. They start each day off with a connection time for everybody. And they have worked to strengthen this simple idea into a powerful tool to create laughter and fun. And most importantly, something that everyone belongs to and has ownership in. It's not all about fun, though. Also, he really focuses on data-driven procedures for student achievement. He's very active in the MTSS process from the day he arrived. He has brought fresh new ideas of collaborating around student data and is instrumental in creating the building process to support the desire of all the adults in the building to keep all of their students in tier one, which is regular everyday education. So while also making sure that all students who need a little extra help get the interventions they need. Ross's daily commitment is a gift to each and every person in the building each and every day. He is present, available, visible, and endlessly supportive to students and staff alike. It's summed up in the final sentence. Ross is a shining star.
This year was amazing for the nomination and just speaks volumes to how fabulous our staff is. And those who are nominated, somebody recognizes that we're going above and beyond even the amazing that we have in our district. So I'm super excited because I have a nurse that we picked. So Ms. Crystal Pearson. So she also had, you know, a lot of nominations. You're well loved. You're obviously very well loved. So something that they said, she's a school nurse at Chester Elementary, and she has consistently demonstrated an outstanding level of dedication and commitment to the well-being of her students. Yeah, I'm a little biased. So she goes above and beyond to ensure that the physical and mental health of our students are met. She's always there to offer advice and support and quickly respond to any concerns that arise. I'm sure you are a security plan. And get in that school. The kid has that become look at this kid, you know. And she's also taken on many additional duties to help our school. She puts in a lot of extra time and effort, and she treats the students that come into her health room her own, which I just love. She's also willing to speak to staff members and give them ideas on how to take care of students with the medical. So she's like a great embodiment of nurses. It's a holistic care, and it's also an educator. I mean, you know, nurses are always teaching about what is your health problem, and just starts teaching and teaching about others how to take care of those that have medical problems. And she's a team player, so like you're a lot in a lot of the collaborations with these kids with their 504 plans. However, she's also kind and caring and empathetic, knowledgeable, and patient. She always meets me with kindness. She's never judgmental, and she always has a smile and never a sigh. And she's always calm, and she doesn't panic, which is obviously huge if you have a medical emergency, right? She takes precious time to read to anxious students who are waiting in their health room. That's definitely huge. And she periodically will stay for after school events for our critical care kids who are participating. And she does it with a smile and never complains. She's also helps to diffuse situations with angry parents or simply help them understand changing protocols. So she's beloved by her staff as well as our students. In fact, we have one student who asked if he could be a nurse for a day. See, she's growing a future nurse already. She is beyond diligent to meet the medical needs of the students, and again, goes out of her way to ensure that they have top-notch care and that she is there for every child. And she meets every single child with the same love and attention that she would with her own. So you give her nomination. Thank you so very much.
I'm telling you, as board president, I didn't choreograph this very well. Stacy Jenkins. Right now, Stacy is working with students as a directed studies instructor, facilitating in-school suspension room along with supervising our students serving lunch detentions. In her role as the instructor through directed studies classes, she fulfills individual content needs for each student that walks through her door, not to mention all of the students that are able to access her expertise throughout the day. There are several students that have built a trusted relationship with Stacy and frequently her room because of her ability. Hats in our building. She continues to go above and beyond to support our kids through her passion and math expertise. In addition to her other roles, Stacy has taken on a Monday through Thursday after school homework club, Math is Cool competition group, and is always available to students before school. Stacy has been a great addition to our building this year. Her ability to take initiative with her position, serve our students in different capacities, and her flexibility in day-to-day change has been commendable. Thank you so much, Stacy, and congratulations.
Everyone in the audience is getting to see all the different roles that it takes to educate our kids. And it's so wonderful that we're able to recognize people from so many different jobs. The next one is Chuck Warner. So Chuck is the custodian at Opportunity Elementary, and I'll read what people have written about Chuck and his role in keeping the school running through after hours, weekends, unexpected events, short staff days where he has to do double duty, probably not unlike many of our custodial staff, but Mr. Chuck Warner continues to provide outstanding service to the staff and students at Opportunity Elementary. Our school continues to be one of the cleanest and most well-maintained buildings in the district. Once again, this year has been a challenging year for our custodial staff. We've spent the majority of the year shorthanded, and Chuck has continued to work tirelessly to ensure our building is beautiful and clean. On top of being an outstanding custodian, Chuck is always kind and supportive towards everyone he encounters during the day. This year, Chuck helped to secure funding to help our school completely revamp our courtyard area into a garden that will provide space for our students to explore hands-on science while providing a beautiful space for our students and staff to learn and relax. We know that when anything in the building comes up, we can call on Chuck day or night, and he will be there for us. We're so fortunate to have Chuck as our head custodian. We are deeply appreciative of everything Chuck does for our students and staff at Opportunity.
I have the privilege of giving an employee team award, and this goes to the school bus drivers, dispatchers, mechanics, and district operations center. Heightened levels of understaffing has occurred in the transportation department due to many retirements and severe illnesses, and et cetera. These employees went above and beyond the ordinary job expectations by running additional routes to regular assigned routes on a daily basis. Often they make adjustments on the fly or by the spur of the moment to pick up additional students and deliver them to the assigned schools and back home again. Dispatchers and mechanics left their regular assigned jobs to become a school bus driver, and somehow they were able to keep up their normal job assignment up to speed. Arrangements were made to see that every student made it to their respective school and back home through this amazing team. It's with great honor, and we're very proud of you for this award.
Thank you.
I have a unique honor in that this year we have combined an employee team with a community group and organization. And we haven't done that before, but we just couldn't see any reason not to this year. For all of those who made the Gifts of Hope 2022 possible, these fine folks are from our district, Donna Boudreau and Linda Tavish. And from our community, Renea Kimmel, Cami Presho, Jenny Spedding, and the volunteers from the Sun City Church. I hope you heard about the wonderful event known as Gifts of Hope. Families were invited to participate in a holiday event where they had the true opportunity for something special and personalized when attending this holiday event. It included personalized invitations, securing childcare, because this was an event where parents would get to pick out presents for their children. It also included hats, coats, and gloves and mittens for everyone who attended. These fine ladies, together with the others who participated, made sure that every one of the participants felt special, wanted, and loved. They provided age-appropriate gifts. They collected them from the community. They interfaced with the community to make sure that everyone had the opportunity to give who wanted to. And just all around ensured that every family had a wonderful personalized experience. This special event could not have been possible without all the collaborative work all of these wonderful folks did. And we are so grateful for what they did on behalf of some of our most precious members. And I did not juggle your flags. I put them up because I would, they don't let me hold things for the wind thing. So when you go shake, just thank you so much.
Our next person is not here, but is a community member who, again, contributed so much to our district outside of school. So it's Jim Durning from Open Eye. And I guess no one's here to receive this plaque. So we'll keep it at the district dark circle. You'll have it. So Open Eye is a very unique business in our community, and it is always supporting Central Valley School District. So this year it sounds like they had a program where they brought kids in and taught them technology, gave them a mentor, and they worked on building a bike. And then the students got to take that bike home. So how fun for the rest of their riding that bike, whatever age they are, they like to take that bike. And then just that mechanics of understanding how it works. So it's just a win-win for our students, for sure. So at the event, because of Jim and his team. What was above and beyond this year is the person who nominated Jim had a student with a disability. And he said that Jim went above, this nomination goes into depth about how Jim went above and beyond and worked with St. Luke's Rehab to figure out a bike for this student. So this student could still attend, the students could still have a bike and learn just like kids that don't have a disability. So it's rare, she said, it's rare to find an individual who is willing to assist and meet the needs of a student who they haven't even met and to do so with help without hesitation. I'll always be grateful to Jim and his team for making a difference in the life of my student. So this is, she kind of spoke broadly about this amazing event, but narrowed it down to how this was so fabulous for the student with a disability. So she has sincere appreciation for Jim, who went above and beyond to help a student just have an amazing experience. So.
I have the opportunity to recognize a community member, Deborah Walker from MultiCare Valley Hospital. While attending a Stop the Bleed training held at Ridgeline High School, the safety and security team had a conversation with the instructor about the availability of Stop the Bleed kits. The instructor, Deborah Walker, asked how they could help Central Valley. Initially, we asked if they could provide the kits to place with all the AEDs in the district, which was 45 kits. Deborah told us that she would be able to provide us those kits at no cost. The conversation did not end there. She then asked what else she could do to help CVSD. We asked if we could possibly get the Stop Bleed kits for every classroom in the district. This equated to almost 2,000 kits. Deborah let us know that she would attempt to make this happen for us. A short time later, she let us know that MultiCare had ordered but would need to help assembling those kits. MultiCare recruited a group of volunteers along with the safety and security team. We spent the day at MultiCare putting together almost 2,000 kits. Those kits have been distributed to every school in the district to place in the classrooms. Deborah also offered to provide the Stop Bleed training to help to any school staff that would be interested. This contribution benefits all schools in the district. So thank you so much, David. I have one last acknowledgement. We'd like to acknowledge she is the one that coordinates it all and tells us where to be. Wouldn't have happened without you. Thank you. And again, we congratulate and thank this year's district-wide Meritorious Service Award recipients for all you've done to contribute to the district and community and our students.